You left rather quickly in the night. Was it something I said?
I found a nanny at your court died suddenly of infection. Without the infirmary having any record of her illness, I decided to return home. Suddenly I felt unsafe.
Oh, I imagine you did. Especially when you found out the nanny did not die of a mysterious infection. She was killed moments after confessing you were the one who organized the assassination attempt on my life.
How troubling.
And yet you seem so untroubled.
People say things, but without proof, they're just words. That's why you tried to catch me in the act of sedition. You have no proof against me. Otherwise, I'd be in the tower right now.
The tower is too good for you. I'll be handing you over to Lord Narcisse instead.
No, you're not. Your rule is tenuous. It always has been. Despite your years on the throne, 50 of your Protestant subjects gathered against you just last night.
And yet none of them have been heard from since.
Because you killed them. So you think that's a show of power, but we both know the truth. You're afraid. That's why you did it quietly, hoping no one would know. But the rumors are already starting to spread. Now, if you give me to Lord Narcisse and I go missing, those 50 will be replaced by 100. Those 100 will raise 1,000 more. Soon you'll have an uprising on your hands.
You think your life is worth that much? You're just a man.
And you are a woman of questionable birth that no one really wants on the throne. Even Mary returned as Queen of Scotland. She's a greater threat than ever yet. You do nothing. Why not send assassins? Because you know that killing another queen only opens the door to someone killing you.
Someone like you. You tried to have me killed and you failed. So take your anti-monarchist poison back to Scotland and direct it towards Mary. Actually do me some good.